And good morning to you. Today is Friday. It is October the 15th, and I am your host, the Troublemaker Extraordinaire, coming to you recorded from the comforts of my Lazy Boy recliner here at Wake Up Central with the TGI Friday edition of the Morning Wake Up Call. Yes, sirree, it is most definitely Friday, and we are on the front step of another weekend, and I am super excited about that. Got some big plans in the mix, and I hope that you do too. And most definitely, I hope you got some family time planned in for your weekend as well. Gotta remember to do the family time. But for right now, I have one thing and one thing only on my mind. And that is, I am happier than a termite in a lumberyard. And buddy, I don't think you could get too much happier than that, my friend. All right, today is Friday, is headlines, and so before we get this show rocking and rolling, let's take a look at the weather forecast for the Jackson-Madison County metro area. Today we are looking at sunny skies. The highs are going to be in the mid-70s. This evening, however, break out the blanket, buddy, because it's going to be clear and the low is going to be in the upper 30s. Man, oh man, I think we're knocking on the front door of wintertime. All right, so here we go. We are at news headlines. First headline here is the Chilean miner story. Ain't that pretty picture right there? The husband and wife sitting there. It was more like a moon landing or a Super Bowl or the most gripping reality TV show you've ever seen. The rescue of 33 miners from what has seemed like their tomb below the Chilean desert was the culmination of a mystic tale of death and reconstruction that briefly unified the world in all delight. After 69 days, the miners have been freed and have been reconnected with their families. If you could get a look at the little picture here. If I can get the, alright. You see the little white thing right here in the center? That is the capsule that they used to bring the guys out of the mine and to the surface. Next news story, Bahama urges voters to get fired up. I'm thinking I just want to fire Bahama. How much longer we got to put up with this freaking clown? Let's see. Economy policies need time to work. President Bahama and Vice President Biden attends the Moving American Forward rally Sunday at a park in the Germantown section of Philadelphia. And so there you have it. You got Bahama and Biden, arm in arm. Looks a little kinky to me, but who knows. All right, next story. Judge says, don't ask, don't tell, must end now. All right, so you know about the don't ask, don't tell. You know, the federal judge ordered on Tuesday an immediate end to enforce the military's don't ask, don't tell ban on lesbian and gay men serving openly in the armed forces. Okay, so they're wanting to stop the don't ask, don't tell deal. Okay, so you got six people right here. You see them in the picture there? They have handcuffed themselves to the fence outside of the White House in protest of don't ask, don't tell. Gasoline can now be 15% ethanol. Critics warn of engine damage. Absolutely. Let's think about this. Ethanol is what? Alcohol? So instead of getting cirrhosis of the liver, you're going to get cirrhosis of the engine. So we're going to be driving around with drunken cars because now we're moving the alcohol level from 10% to 15%. Our cars will be going to AA meetings now. All right, technology news here. I'll get it out in a minute. Apple share surpassed the $300 milestone. Apple Incorporated, you know, Steve Jobs, and the iPod and the iThis and the iThat and the iCare, they have hit a huge milestone. Their stock has topped $300 per share. There's only a very few stocks out there, including Berkshire Hathaway, Google, Washington Post, and Priceline.com, who are over the $300 per share milestone. So congratulations to Mr. Steve. I'm sure your bank account is quite happy at the moment. Meanwhile, the rest of us just float along. All right, this is a cool story. ICE is back with a brand new profession. You remember the old the guy Vanilla Ice, you know, Ice, Ice, baby, do 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 do. Well, he's back on the scene now. Vanilla Ice is blasting his way into living rooms with the Vanilla Ice Project. The rapper, who is forever linked to his hit single Ice, Ice, Baby from the 1990 album To the Extreme. Yes, I owned that album. I knew every word of Ice, Ice, Baby. He has now gone into real estate. And Robert Van Winkle, otherwise known as Vanilla Ice, has now got a TV show talking about how to flip real estate. What floats your boat, buddy? This kind of touches me. The Braves sad about their exit, but Cox finale was grand. I am a very huge Atlanta Braves fan. My late grandfather was a big Atlanta Braves fan, and after he passed away, I began watching the Braves more religiously and more regularly, and I kind of thought that this was going to be the year for the boys. Unfortunately, they did not make it. It's kind of bad, but then this is Bobby Cox. Last year, he has managed the Braves for 29 seasons. The Braves dugout will not be the same. All right, speaking of baseball postseason action, here we go. It's the Yankees and the Rangers tonight at 8 o'clock. And then tomorrow, postseason action. You've got the Giants and the Phillies at 7:30. So, there you go, boys and girls. News you can use if you choose. I've got a couple of minutes left here, so let's take a look at the quote of the day. I shall never be ashamed of citing a bad author if the line is good. That comes from Cynthia, I guess is how you say that, not sure. Anyway, useless information. The average child recognizes over 200 company logos by the time they reach first grade. I have absolutely no doubt that is true. All right, that is today's show. I hope you have enjoyed the show as much as I have, getting the show put together, working with my staff, and I love doing this. This is so awesome, and I'm glad that I've got people out there that actually enjoy watching this, because if it was not for you, I would not have a reason to do this, okay? But anyway, I will be back here Monday with the Monday edition of Wake Up Call. In the meantime, I hope you all have a wonderful day and a wonderful weekend. Before I split out of here, you know what I'm going to do is call the legal mumbo jumbo. The lawyers make me do it. The views and opinions expressed on the show are those of the host, guest, and fans, not necessarily those of any organization represented by these individuals. Wake Up Call is a production of free speech and communication. May be replayed at any time for your viewing pleasure. The content of this show are meant to only be entertaining and possibly sarcastic. Should you have any issues regarding the show, you're encouraged for or any and all comments to my Facebook account. Well, boys and girls, that is today's show. I got here my very special girl. This is my little baby. This is Maggie Moose. Say hi, Maggie. All right, yeah. Lay back down. All right, boys and girls, I am headed back to the bed. Gonna catch me a couple of winks before I go back to work at 3 o'clock this afternoon. So, in the meantime, I like the inverted belly button. I'm out of here.